إن كان هناك من يفهم يسمى لأنهم من أهل العلم.
And he says, this is if you want to even consider who is it actually that is the person, are the people of knowledge that we're talking about, are they really qualified or deserving of the title that they should be called with being this title of from the people of knowledge?
لأننا ندين الله ونعتقد جازمين أن العلم ليس هو أن يقرأ الفقيه بل المتفقه كتابا من كتب مذهب من المذاهب الأربع المتبعة.
The Sheikh, he says this is because he said we believe with absolute conviction that knowledge is not that a faqih or a jurist or one who's just seeking to be a faqih, considered a faqih or seeking to understand information, that he just reads. This knowledge is not that this person just reads from the books of the four madhabs that, which are followed by the people, the four imams, the four madhabs, just read from those books of those four madhabs, rather, which the people follow and consider, think that they're supposed to be followed. And the Shaykh says from the madhabs of the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, these four well-known madhabs, the Hanafi, the Maliki, the Shafi'i, and the Hanbali, he says, ilm is not that a person just reads into those four books and just takes whatever he finds there, or just reads whatever he finds of one of the madhabs that he's following.
إنه لا يدري أهذا الذي قرأه هو ثابت بالكتاب أم بالسنة.
And then after reading this information, the person, he doesn't even know whether this information which he's read in that one madhab he's following, whether it's confirmed from the book or from the book of Allah, meaning the Quran, or something confirmed from the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أم بإجماع الأمة.
Or is it something that's confirmed from the ijma', the consensus, of the agreement, agreed upon consensus of the Ummah of Islam, the Ummah.
وأن هذا الإجماع إن كان منقولا هل هو إجماع ثابت صحيح؟
Or whether this ijma, this consensus that is claimed and been conveyed in the books, is it a ijma that is confirmed and authentic? Is it a correct ijma?
أم ثبت ذلك بالقياس؟
Or has that thing been, that he read about, has it been confirmed by his analogical deduction, qiyas? Or is it something that has been approved by just by mere opinion or by just discovery, of the, sometimes a discovered opinion, istinbat or ra'i? And is this qiyas, is it a qiyas that is apparent, or is it a qiyas that is khafiyan, hidden qiyas, or unclear, concealed type of qiyas? And is it sahih, authentic, correct, or is it da'if, is it weak?
ليس الفقه أن يقرأ كتابا من تلك الكتب ثم هو لا يدري من أين جاءت هذه المسائل التي يقرأها.
So the Shaykh says, fiqh is not one just reading from these books and then taking from them, and yet the person doesn't even know from where this these issues, where the evidence has come concerning these issues which he's read about. He doesn't even know where the where this is coming from, these the conclusions from these views. This is not fiqh, he says. Then he said the person, after reading blindly from those books and not knowing how to decipher the information, whether it's correct or not, from those madhab books, then he bases opinions on those views or those things which he has read, and then he starts spreading them, not even knowing whether that information is correct or not, or not even being able to decipher whether that information is correct or not. He said, this is not ilm, and this is not fiqh. He said, this is not ilm, this is not knowledge like this.
العلم كما قال ذلك القائل العالم المحقق حقا ألا وهو ابن قيم الجوزي رحمه الله.
His knowledge is just as it has been said by that the speaker, the sayer, the one who made the statement, this alim, this great alim, the great scholar. He said, verily, is this scholar is Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. May Allah have mercy on him. He said, the knowledge of this religion is Allah said, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and then to the end of his statement. And he said, but now, today, you barely can even find someone who's considered a alim, a scholar, a person of knowledge, in reality, who's deserving the right of this title, an alim, a person of knowledge. He said, that is one who is spreading the statements of the Prophet ﷺ, the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ amongst the people, and not only that, but he's spreading the authentic, the sahih narrations of the Prophet ﷺ amongst the people, a true alim. The Shaykh says everything that's attributed to the Prophet ﷺ attributed to the Messenger of Allah ﷺ is not confirmed and authentic. Everything that's just attributed to him. He says, so as I said before, this is not knowledge, the one who who's spreading knowledge that he's not sure about. This is not people, the person, this does not confirm. This is not the person of knowledge. He said, actually, knowledge is as it was said by Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, the knowledge is Allah said, and the Prophet ﷺ said, and not just that, but the person also is spreading those narrations of the Prophet ﷺ. They're using those narrations of the Prophet ﷺ, which are authentic. And not only are they spreading his statements that are authentic, but then they're spreading the information, the sunnah of his deeds that are confirmed, the Prophet's actions, which are authenticated and confirmed as well. And he says, and from these statements which are sahih and authentic of the Prophet ﷺ, that statement which has been agreed upon by the two sheikhs, Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim.
Al-Bukhari wa Muslim, rahimahullah tabarak wa ta'ala. Iza amman al-imam fa'amminu. Fa'innahu man wafaqa ta'minuhu ta'min al-malaika ghufira lahu ma taqaddam min dhanbihi.
He says that hadith was reported by Bukhari and Muslim. May Allah have mercy on both of them. What the Prophet ﷺ said, when the Imam says Ameen, then the followers, the people, then you all say Ameen. For verily, whoever is Ameen, saying of Ameen, agrees with the Ameen of the angels, he will be forgiven for what is preceded of his previous sin. He said, in the way of our Salaf, the pious predecessors, the early people of Islam, when they heard an authentic sunnah, when they heard a sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, even less than this hadith in reference to importance, and this hadith, and every statement of the Prophet ﷺ, hadith of the Prophet ﷺ is considered important. But he said, we do know that the hadith, they have the statements of the Prophet ﷺ have various levels. For example, the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ that alludes to something that's obligatory is not like the hadith that just alludes to something that is preferred and not obligatory. So anyway, our Salaf used to say, thank you.